Hello, this is Solar PVTV once again from Rest for Africa event here in Addis Ababa in Ethiopia. And now we are together with Antonello Camisecra, CEO of NL Green Power. So I would like to say, first of all, thank you because Antonello asked me to come here in person to Addis Ababa. And actually, it's so great, yes, because I promise also to come to Mr. Meles, who is the State Minister of Industry. So grazie mille. Thank you so much, Antonello. And I would like to ask you just very shortly, yes, because we had this discussion, you know, the panel discussion with the ministers, and we were speaking about the vision, yes, but you said, Tomasz, let's not speak about too much about the vision, because actually we are making so great job at the presence.
Right.
And could you justify that?
Yes, we don't want to skip the discussion about vision. I think it's a very important point. I mean, looking forward, especially for a company like us that, well, we have the ambition to drive in our sector, having a leadership, it's very important. So vision is okay. I mean, we must, let's say, push hard to create a vision of a better future. But we're in Africa, and we have a lot of issues and problems, especially in the electricity access. And so, speaking of futures, I like to say implicitly, come on guys, we're thinking of a brighter future, give us time, we'll deliver a solution also for you. I mean, the answer and the solutions must be now. So now, with the existing paradigm, there is a lot of things that we can do now. At the same time, Africa can benefit from a leapfrog. So they have not gone through all the evolution that we experienced in Europe and in Americas through the implementation of gigawatts and gigawatts in 10 years. So they can benefit from the best technology available today at the cost that is available today, which is very competitive. So the present is much brighter than our present 10 years ago. So my point is, the present is okay, and if we work in the present, then the vision will come, and it will be a brighter vision.
Exactly, because actually, what I noticed in your speech that you have, you know, like 500 megawatts of renewables, yes?
Correct. We have 500 in Africa, 500 megawatts in wind and solar in South Africa, but we are also working hard in Morocco with our partner Nareva for the 850 megawatt wind project. But we are also expecting the after the awarding to sign the PPAs for additional 700 megawatt in South Africa in wind. Then we have Zambia. We're building a 34 megawatt solar under the Scaling Solar Program, which is also in Ethiopia, as you know. And then we're waiting also the results of the first tender in Ethiopia, where we have participated. So Africa for us is becoming a very important region, a very important continent in the general, let's say, landscape of NL Green Power, which is a global operator. So, but Africa for us, it's very important. And it's a present, also the future, but also the present.
Exactly. But let's speak about the past now.
Yes.
Because you are a person who was, you know, like a first pioneer of emerging markets at NL Green Power. And recently we noticed with some friends that now the emerging markets are becoming the major markets, yes?
Yeah, as you said, I was formerly the business development manager together with Mr. Starace and Francesco Venturini. We have been, let's say, brave and courageous to go in difficult markets, sometimes taking the lead, being the first mover. And I think this was very good for us, but also for the country where we operated, but also because this created a sense of exploration, I mean, in the management team of NL Green Power, which is important in renewables, especially when you want to work in emerging economies. So I think the most in the emerging markets yet has to happen. So for me, this is country for developments, for business development, for project development. It's the most lacking capabilities, in my opinion, in our industry. So I think it's emerging markets will quickly become emerged economies in renewables if we work all together. And today, I think, it's the witness of, it's a real example of cooperation between the local institutions, local stakeholders, and international operators. I want to use a very broad meaning of in the terms of operator, because there are utilities like us, technology providers, but also universities, research centers, journalists, the newspapers, so all possible stakeholders that around the concept of creating a better future, so the vision again, are working to have a brighter present.
Exactly. And last question, because you are president of Rest for Africa, I would like to ask you, what are the plans for the because now we are finishing the year. The next event, the last event of Race for Africa will be in Kenya,
yes,
in December. But what are your plans actually for the year 2018?
So thank you very much for reminding us. December event in Kenya, it's following the 1 year ago event. It was the first in Kenya. So for 2018, we'll do likewise Kenya. We will do a refresh in Ethiopia. It will be the occasion to make a status check of the program that are ongoing. So for sure, there will be another event in Ethiopia. From a global perspective, Race for Africa will focus, and Race for Med, we have two names now, so we'll focus on sustainability. This year was the year of innovation. Next year will be the focus on sustainability, so how to deliver a sustainable economical and social development through renewable energy.
Do you agree with my know-how, actually, that we should not speak about sustainability, but sustainability plus? Yes, so actually not sustaining, but improving, especially on the emerging markets.
I agree with you. Actually, I think you have stolen this concept from us, because, I'm joking, of course, because we believe the following. Many players in the industry, in the renewable industry, believe that they are sustainable per se, just because you are renewable, so CO2-free, emissions-free, that means that you are, this is a big, big mistake. We bring with us an inevitable footprint, which is impacting the environment in which we operate. So the consciousness of the footprint that we have with, I mean, implicitly within us, must be what drives us for more sustainable solutions. Think about, we are investing, creating new renewable plants, but doing that, we are analyzing any single steps in the construction phase to minimize and mitigate the impact of our presence in a given territory, in a given location. So being renewables, it's not equivalent to being sustainable and zero impact. You have to work on this concept to become sustainable plus, as you say.
To have positive impact, not zero impact.
Exactly. So to improve the environment, not only from an environmental point of view, but actually more importantly, from a socio-economical point of view. So sustainable plus is a concept that I like. Well done.
To build a sustainable plus future today.
Today, absolutely.
Okay, thank you so much. That was Solar PVTV from Addis Abeba, from Ethiopia, together with Antonello Camisecra, who is president of Race for Africa and also CEO of NL Green Power, one of the most visionary companies in utility space, the company which is building the future today. Thanks for watching.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.